Welcome to the muscular system. This is a really fun organ system to explore because much of it focuses on skeletal muscles. The skeletal muscles of your body are the voluntary muscles that you're probably familiar with because you may have done exercise in your life, and so you might be familiar with your quads, your hamstrings, your traps, your lats, your biceps. But there are a lot more skeletal muscles than just those, and so we're going to learn a lot of the names of those muscles. We will also explore the microanatomy of skeletal muscles, particularly skeletal muscle cells, so that we can understand muscle contraction. Now, recall from our module on tissue that there are actually three types of muscle tissue: skeletal muscle tissue, cardiac muscle tissue, and smooth muscle tissue. Like I said, much of this module focuses on skeletal muscle tissue, but it's important to remember that the other two types of muscle tissue are also part of the muscular system. So let's review the three types of muscle tissue. Skeletal muscle tissue is found in all of your voluntary muscles of your body. The cells are characterized as being long and cylindrical and multinucleated. Overall, the tissue appears striated, sort of a banded or striped appearance. And in this module, we're going to explore why that is. There's an intracellular structure called the sarcomere that gives muscle tissue, skeletal muscle tissue, and actually cardiac muscle tissue as well, that striated appearance. Cardiac muscle tissue is found in the wall of the heart. When that muscle contracts, it pushes blood through the chambers of the heart. Cardiac muscle is not voluntary, and we describe cardiac muscle cells as being short and branched and uni or binucleated. Smooth muscle tissue, very different to the other two types of muscle tissue, is not striated. Those cells are uninucleated, and we describe the shape as fusiform. And remember, smooth muscle is not voluntary. It's controlled by the autonomic nervous system and surrounds hollow organs. And when smooth muscle tissue contracts, it pushes some sort of substance through it. If it's surrounding the urinary bladder, it will push urine through it. If it's a blood vessel, it will push blood through it. If it's the uterus, it would push a fetus through it. Okay? Now, the functions of the muscular system are not only to produce movement. In our first module, the Introduction to Human Anatomy, we said, oh, the muscular system's function is to produce movement. Definitely, that's the primary function. To move the skeleton and produce facial expression if it's skeletal muscle, to move blood through the heart if it's cardiac muscle tissue, or to propel a substance through a passageway if it is smooth muscle tissue. However, other functions include the opening and closing of body passageways. One very good example is the orbicularis oris. That's a circular muscle that surrounds your mouth. It is your mouth. And that muscle controls ingestion, the intake of food and fluid into your body as part of the digestive process. Another important muscle, the external anal sphincter, is surrounding the anus and it opens and closes and permits the exit of material, waste material, also part of the digestive system. Throughout your body, there are also circular muscles like the pyloric sphincter, the esophageal sphincter, the ileocecal valve. All of these are internal, smooth muscles that open and close autonomically, allowing that substance to pass from one organ to another. Another important function, the maintenance of posture and the stabilization of joints. As you're sitting in your chair right now, skeletal muscles, so voluntary muscles, are contracting to keep you upright. When you're standing, there are muscles that stabilize your hip joint. And you don't realize it, but that is occurring. All muscle contraction requires energy, and in the process of creating energy, ATP, heat is emitted. And heat, of course, contributes to our body temperature. On the next page, we're going to talk about the four properties of all muscle tissue.